Students, in this video, now we are going to start a new chapter, Lines and Angles. The part of mathematics that deals with such objects as points, lines, planes, and space is called geometry. First heading is points. Points are exact locations in space and are named by using capital letters. They are shown by small dots. Naming a point. A point is designated by a capital letter which is written next to the dot which represent it. Example, point A, point C, point B. In this way, we can name a point. The next heading is line. Lines have no endings. They go on and on. The representation of a line has only length and no width or thickness. That means a line has only length. Representation of a line. A line has no endpoints. A line extends infinitely in both directions. We can name the line as line PQ or line QP. It is also written as this is symbol of line PQ or symbol of line QP. So this is the line PQ, and in this way we can name the line PQ. The next heading is few facts about lines. First, there are an unlimited number of points on a line. So whenever we draw a line, on that line we can found there are many number of points like A, B, C, D, E. These all points lying on this line. The next subheading. There are an unlimited number of lines through a point. So here in the center you can see there is a point, and through this point you can draw number of unlimited lines. The next third heading is two lines can intersect in only one point. So when we intersect two lines, they both can intersect at only one point. Next, exactly one line passes through two points. So only from two points we can draw a line. The next heading is plane. A plane can be thought of as a flat surface. A plane is named by marking three points that not has to be not in a straight line on it. All points on the lines AB, BC lie in the plane. So here you can see that we can take a flat surface and all the three points are not lying on a same line. So that will be called a plane. In a plane, the points will not lie in a same line. The next heading is vertical and horizontal line. The line in which the front wall and side wall of a classroom meet in a vertical line. So in this way, we can draw a vertical line. The next, the line between the ceiling and a wall in your classroom is a horizontal line. So the line between your ceiling and a wall, that line will be called a horizontal line. Now this is your home assignment. Thank you.